Hi, it's me again. Some time ago, I was feeling a bit under the weather. I was having a high fever and symptoms of a cold, so since we are in these special times right now, I feared it might be...
Cucumber?
No, Corona.
Because of that, and because some of you asked us in the previous videos. So I think it's about time that we explain what happened to Sweden and also to us during this global pandemic.
Chapter 1. The Swedish Government.
Let's rewind a bit to the beginning. Even though Sweden had a few cases in the beginning of 2020, it wasn't until March when the Public Health Agency of Sweden couldn't track the spread anymore. The virus was out of control. Unlike many other countries, Sweden didn't close down its borders or infer any lockdown, however. A lot of recommendations were made, but the list of prohibitions is actually very short.
When global media mentions how Sweden has combated the virus, they assume that we're going for herd immunity. If you don't know what it is, it basically means that they thought our plan was for everyone to get infected over time. It's actually not what we were going for, but the government assumed that people were smart enough to follow the recommendation and keep the spread down, without having to put in mandates.
Chapter 2. The society.
While the government puts its trust in citizens, many office workers were told to work from home since March 2020. Retail shops has limited their opening hours, and now bars and restaurants are not even allowed to keep open and serve food and drinks after 8:30 p.m. For the time that the bars and clubs are open, you're forced to stay seated, so there's no chance of mingling around or showing your latest dance moves. In some food courts, they even have the rule to only sit one person per table.
As you might have seen in our previous video, our local IKEA just shut down the entire cafeteria. However, lots of buffets and gyms don't seem to be bothered by these recommendations. Some places did close between March and May 2020, but soon reopened and no one seemed to care that much.
Chapter 3. The waves.
If you look at this curve, showing the number of daily new confirmed COVID-19 cases in Sweden, you can see that by the end of the summer in 2020, it looked like our minimal efforts were enough and the virus was gone. I think at this point, people who had taken precautions started to relax. For the people who hadn't changed their lifestyle, why would they start now?
Introducing wave number 2! Turns out you actually do have to take actions if you want to keep the spread of the virus down. After the New Year's, when people realized that just because we entered 2021, it doesn't mean that there's no more corona, I guess people got their shit together and the spread did decrease. It lasted about as long as people's New Year's resolutions, and then people just went back to their old habits.
Chapter 4. COVID testing.
As the health system was overloaded when COVID-19 first broke out in Sweden, the government decided to only test people that are in high-risk groups, such as elders and people with other underlying conditions. If you were young or otherwise healthy, but start to show symptoms of corona, you were told just to stay at home, rest, and avoid meeting people.
Later in the year, more money was put into testing. And when I got my symptoms earlier this year, I actually did qualify for testing. All I had to do was download an app on my phone and fill in my information. And then some dude in a taxi came with a cotton swab and a test tube and just dropped it off at my home. He said that he would be back in 10 minutes, so I just took the cotton swab and put it in all the appropriate holes and packaged it up for him to pick up. Luckily, the test came back negative and I was feeling better just after resting for a few days.
Chapter 5. The future.
COVID-19 has been in our life for over a year now. We haven't been able to travel around, meet our friends or family as often as we'd like, or even have a proper wedding. Hopefully, this will change relatively soon as the vaccine is becoming more and more available.
The vaccine was first given to those in need, such as medical personnel and the elderly. But today, you can book vaccinations here in Stockholm if you're born
1971
or earlier. Looks like soon we'll be getting our 5G chips.
Can't wait!
Anyway, that's all we have for you today. Don't forget to click on that like button if you actually did like the video.
Subscribing is free and it will tell you when we upload the next video. See you next week!
Yeah.